but 44-year-old Tom Brady is second in the NFL in passing yards and tied for third in passing touchdowns. His hot start has made him, quote, comfortably the best graded quarterback by Pro Football Focus, earning him a spot on their NFL first quarter All-Pro team. So, Shannon, how big of a problem do you got with this?
I have a huge problem, and Tom Brady should not even be a top three. He shouldn't be on the first team, the second team, the third team, or the fourth team. Now, Brady is 19th in completion percentage. Kyler Murray is first. Tom Brady is 16th in yards per attempt. Kyler Murray is second. Tom Brady is 8th in QBR. Kyler Murray is 3rd. Kyler Murray has 4 turnovers. Tom Brady has 3 turnovers. I just don't. And the thing, what I'm looking at is that Kyler Murray went to the Rams and beat, not just beat them, they beat them up. Beat the brakes off them. The very team that the week before had just beat the brakes off of Tom Brady. So I'm confused. He's 4-0. His team is the number one scoring offense, averaging 35 points a game. And we just saw Tom Brady get outplayed in back-to-back weeks. He got outplayed by Matthew Stafford. He got outplayed by Mac Jones. He lost the first one, won the second one. But he got outplayed. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. And so for me, when I look at it, and they keep talking about Tom Brady has no turnover-worthy plays. Tom Brady got hit and fumbled the ball against the Atlanta Falcons. He got strip sacked. Is that not a turnover-worthy play? So what is a turnover-worthy play? I hit the guy. The guy fumbles the ball. That's not a turnover-worthy play.
Talking about throws.
He threw the ball into a crowd. Is that not a turnover-worthy play?
It is not.
Why?
And you disqualified it the next day on the show. You sat right there and said, I'm not going to dock him for that one. He just took a shot at the end of the half. You throw a jump ball and hope that Gronk jumps and catches
it. So, in other words, that's a turnover-worthy play because you threw the ball and you put the ball in harm's way.
No, now, you intentionally put the ball in harm's way.
Skip, if the results are the same, intent only matters to the person that's committing the act.
What is this, a court of law?
Yeah, because that's what I be trying to tell people. Intent. Intent only matters to the defender. The victim is just as hurt or just as dead.
There's no victim here.
Yes, it is. If Kyler Murray.
It did not matter. It was end of half, fling it up and hope. Hail Mary.
So let me ask you a question. Would they have given him a touchdown had Gronk or Mike Evans caught it?
Sure.
So in other words, you gave him a touchdown, but you don't want to give him a turnover because you're like, he just throwed it up in hope. I'm confused. But everybody knows, Tom Brady has the most passing yards, but who has the most passing attempts? He doesn't have, he's 19th in completion percentage. Tom Brady's the most accurate. Bing, bing, bing. Somebody, bing, bing, bing. He's 19th? You mean to tell me there's 18 guys better than Tom Brady in completion percentage?
Tell me when it's my turn, please.
It's your turn.
Shannon Sharp, your Brady hate does not become.
It ain't no hate. It's the facts.
It's facts. I just hope our viewers, our dear viewers, can sit back right now and let this sink in, what this man is doing at age 44 or 24. It doesn't really matter. But I'm going to read the quotes from the backup here from Pro Football Focus as they explain why they're saying that he's far and away the best graded quarterback so far in four games.
Yeah, I want to hear this one.
What Brady continues to do is not normal. To even be a functioning starting quarterback at 44 is extremely unlikely. Obviously, you would agree with that.
Yes.
But to be the best in the NFL is madness.
But he's not.
It's madness.
Okay, well, give me some numbers.
Brady does not yet have a turnover-worthy play, and he doesn't. And he has only 12 in the time he's been with Bruce Arians, which is a no-risk-it, no-biscuit offense, which is high-risk and somewhat high reward. It's medium reward.
That was before the bye week. Once the bye week came, have we been seeing the bombs away just to throw the ball? So is he still number one in air distance?
I don't know. I haven't checked that.
He's not.
But he is number one in getting rid of the football because it's 2.41 seconds to protect himself and his offensive line, and it works. Everybody can do the same. Everybody can get rid of it in 2.41, but they're just not capable of reading and cutting loose in 2.41 seconds because he's genius. He is the genius speed reader of the ages.
Skip, The reason why is that they diagrammed it, that there's a lot of short throws, there's a lot of crossing route, there's a lot of hitches, there's a lot of things that gets the ball out of his hand. Patrick, the reason why he's so far in yards per attempt is because he's doing what we call shore fishing. He's fishing right there around the edge.
I'm going to show you some longer throws here in just a second.
My homeboy and Kyler Murray, they deep sea fish. Patrick, okay. Matthew Stafford, they go out to catch the big fish.
Okay, I'm glad you brought that up. Let's go to opening night against my Cowboys, who were drastically underrated going into that game. What did he do in the end? He led yet another fourth quarter comeback drive to a walk-off field goal featuring some huge passes, one to Gronk for 20 yards. But let's go to the pass of the game. The throw of the night was second and 10 at the Dallas Cowboy 42. This is crucial. This is only 24 seconds left. Back he drops, and I'd say that's not shore fishing. I think that's a deeper route because that went for 24 yards to Chris Godwin, and that sets up the suck-up walk-off field goal. It's big-time clutch throw because he is the clutchest playmaker I've ever seen in any sport, including Michael Jordan, who just didn't have as many opportunities to be as clutch as Tom has been over 21 years of pro football. It's unbelievable.
Okay.
Then let's go to game two. It's at home against Atlanta, and all he did was throw for 5 touchdowns. Okay. Then let's go to game 3 at Rams. He threw for 432 yards, albeit in a loss.
Albeit empty calories. Go ahead, though.
Empty calories. It was 34-24, and they're onside kicking to even cut it.
Skip there. Down 17, okay. Basically the whole game. Stop.
Okay.
It.
432 still stands up as the most yards any quarterback this whole season has thrown for in regulation of any of the games we've seen so far. 4-3-2 against a defense, you told me, it might be the best in pro football, right? 432, I don't care empty calories. I don't care what kind of calories you say they are. High calories, low calories, they're just calories.
So let me ask you a question. Did any of those touchdowns, any of those yards, put them in the lead of the ball game? Did they lead at any point in time in the ball game?
No. But again, they were obviously looking ahead as the Rams played their Super Bowl. And Coach McYay is running all over the field, butt slapping and running up in the tunnel. Yeah. And it's their Super Bowl game while everybody's mind on the Buccaneers is in Foxborough.
So if that was the case, why didn't they play better? Why didn't they score 30 points against the Patriots? If everybody's mind was on the Patriots, if that was their focus, why did they only get 19 points?
That's a great question because I told you, I predicted this, I first guessed it, that Brady would be over-emotional and over-amped in the first quarter. Even you said that on the show
the next day.
But then when he settled in, can we see the throws that he started to make that were not cashed by his teammates, please? Can we see the first one to Mike Evans? This is a touchdown right here. This is a 6'5" receiver. It hits him right in the hands, if we can see it from the end zone shot. That's a Pro Bowl receiver. That well could have gone right to the end zone. Here's Cameron Brate. That's a 20-yard completion right there. And then here we go again to AB. What a sweet throw. Is that shore fishing? And again, that got called back. You said it's hands to the face, whatever. But here we go to AB. You want to talk about clutch? This is 2 minutes left, and he throws a home run. A rainbow home run to AB, and he just loses it in the lights.
He says,
I'm going right back to it, and I'm going to throw a rope to him. I'm going to throw a rocket. You've got to catch this. If you're a former multiple Pro Bowl receiver in Antonio Brown, it's as clutch a throw as you will ever see because that's ball game. That was going to slam the door on Bill Belichick. And he said, okay, if he lost the first one in the lights, I'm going right back to him, and I'm going to throw it a little lower, more on a line. I'm going to throw him a rocket, and I'm going to hit him right in the hands on the back line.
Okay.
You just have to snag it. If those catches get made, if the one penalty is not called, I thought it was just ticky-tack, but if it's not called, he's way over 300 yards, and he still had decent numbers, and he still had a better QBR than Mac Jones did, 55-46. And you said Brady got outplayed. No, he didn't.
Yes, he did. Skip, here's the thing. Is that what you try to do? If you look at the Cowboys defense have yet to hold a quarterback under 300 yards passing. Mm. So let's disregard them. You talk about the Atlanta Falcons. Everybody throws for 3. Jalen Hurts had 3 touchdowns and 300 yards. Tyler Heineke had 3 touchdowns and 300 yards. So what?
Anybody have 5?
Huh?
5?
Tyler Heineke.
Okay.
The guy that's only in his third NFL start in his career did that.
Or Taylor. Either way.
Taylor Heineke, excuse me. I can't know. My bad.
Okay,
my bad.
He deserves Taylor. To be called Tyler.
No, he doesn't. No, he doesn't. Yeah. You're going to be... You keep talking about it, but you're going to see him up close and personal.
You did it. I didn't do
it. You're going to see him up close and personal. Okay. He's going to throw for three touchdowns against y'all.
Okay, good.
But, Skip, what you try to do is that when Tom Brady loses, you put it on when he dropped it. Skip, if I could go back and say, well, Matthew Stafford, and show you throws that he missed Sunday, if he makes this throw right here, they win the game, or he has 400-plus yards. Mm. You can't say that, but what you're doing is that the man fumbled the football, and you said that wasn't a turnover-worthy play. He throws a pick. Now, you can't get credit if it's a catches it, it's a touchdown, but it goes the other way, an interception.
You told me the next day it's not a turnover-worthy play.
No,
you said that.
No. I said I don't have a problem with him throwing
that.
Okay,
then it's not turnover-worthy. It's a Hail Mary.
So why throw it?
Okay, wait a second. You could argue every Hail Mary is turnover-worthy.
Yes!
Because you have to risk
throwing
it up
for grabs. Yes, thank you!
You are literally throwing it up for grabs, hoping that one of your guys wins a jump ball or a tip ball.
Thank you, Skip.
Okay, but it's not turnover-worthy by their grading system because they disqualify it because anybody who does that at the end of the half, you're off the hook.
Well, here's the thing, Skip. You do realize every time you put the ball up in the air is a turnover-worthy play. Because there's distance between where you're throwing the ball and where the guy's going to catch it. Mm. And there's normally defenders on the field. So theoretically, everything can be considered a turnover-worthy play.
Well, if I show you tape of Carson Wentz, he'll throw six or eight a game that you'll say, oh, my God, because that should have been intercepted. That's called a turnover-worthy play.
Skip. There are times that plays should be intercepted. There have been times that plays should be caught. It's called football. Mm. But what they're trying to do, I just need to know what criteria, because I'm looking at Kyler Murray's stats. I'm looking at Matthew Stafford numbers.